मल्टीवाइब्रेटर इज एन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट यूज्ड टू इम्प्लीमेंट अ वैरायटी ऑफ सिंपल टू स्टेट डिवाइस सच एज ऑसिलेटर टाइमर्स एंड फ्लिप फ्लॉप. देयर इज अ क्लास ऑफ आरसी कपल्ड ऑसिलेटर्स विच जनरेट नॉन साइनसोइडल वेव फॉर्म्स सच एज स्क्वायर वेव्स रेक्टेंगुलर वेव्स. अ फ्री रनिंग मल्टीवाइब्रेटर सर्किट इज अ फ्रीक्वेंटली यूज्ड सर्किट फॉर जनरेटिंग स्क्वायर वेव सिग्नल्स. इन दिस किट वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड और स्टडी द ऑपरेशन ऑफ अस्टेबल मल्टीवाइब्रेटर टू स्टडी द वेवफॉर्म्स एट वेरियस प्लेस ऑफ सर्किट्स एंड टू स्टडी द ऑपरेशन ऑफ इम्प्रूव्ड अस्टेबल सर्किट एंड ऑब्जर्व द आउटपुट वेवफॉर्म ऑफ दैट सर्किट ऑल्सो. सो नाउ वी मूव ऑन टू द सर्किट डिस्क्रिप्शन एंड द एक्सपेरिमेंट. So this is our trainer kit. So this is the transistor S-stable multivibrator trainer kit. The order code for this trainer kit is 36127. We are also providing a user manual for descriptions and experiment included in this. Also patch code for the accessories. So this is the circuit of transistor S-stable multivibrator. In this circuit, the two transistors are connected in common collector. So this is our circuit of transistor S-stable multivibrator. In this circuit, the two transistors are coupled in common emitter stages that are coupled together with impedances. Also, there is two potentiometers of 100k each to provide the various resistances in the circuit. Now we move on to the first objective, which is to study the operation of transistors S-stable multivibrator. For this we have to complete the circuit with this practical diagram using the patch codes. So we will connect this terminal now we move on to the first objective, which is to study the operation of a transistor free multivibrator. For this we have to make the connection given as per the circuit diagram. Circuit diagram is given in the manual. For this we will connect one terminal of VC1 capacitor to one terminal of C1 capacitor. The other terminal of C1 capacitor will be connected to potentiometer. Similarly, one terminal of VC2 capacitor to other terminal of C2, and other terminal of C2 to the potentiometer. So this is our first circuit, which is done. Now for explaining the circuit, in this circuit resistor R3 and R4 are the load resistors for the two transistors. To analyze the circuit, we assume it is oscillating. When power is applied to transistor, will conduct more than other due to some circuit imbalances. That means one circuit or one transistor conduct more than the other transistor due to the imbalance at the start of the circuit. So we assume T1 is conducting and T2 is cut off. Then VC1 is approximately 0 volt and VC2 is approximately 9 volt. Meanwhile, the capacitor C1 had previously charged up to 9 volt when T2 was conducting through R3. But when T1 conducts, a path is provided for C1 to discharge through T1. And R5
combination of RB1 plus VR1 in manner. This circuit explanations are of charging and discharging this capacitor and conducting of transistors are shown in this circuit also. All the descriptions of this circuit conducting of multivibrator is also provided in this manual. So now we power on this circuit and observe the output on the board terminals, which are A and B. These are the output of multivibrator. For this we connect CRO ground terminal to ground and one terminal to B. And we can observe the waveform of output at the CRO. Similarly, at A point, the waveform is shown at the CRO. For this, we have to calculate the rise time and fall time, which are already measured by CRO. Now for the experiment, table number 1, the marking readings of frequencies can be varied with this potentiometers. You can see the output at the oscilloscope, that as I vary the potentiometer, the frequency of output also varies. Note down the frequency value for different positions of the potentiometer and calculate also the frequency with the theoretical values and compare them together. This is the first experiment. Now we move on to the second experiment. Second objective, we will study the waveform at various places of this circuit. For this, the circuit connections remains the same as well the last experiment. Now we power on the circuit and observe the waveform at the different points. The first point is observing point A, which is shown at oscilloscope. Now we observe the waveform at point B, which is shown at the oscilloscope. The output waveforms are given in the manual. You can observe. This is the waveform of VC1 and VC2. With respect to time, now we will observe the waveform of VB1 . This is the waveform of VB1 . This is the waveform of VB2 . For this, we have to calculate the rise time and fall time, also pulse width, with the help of CRO. The all values can be measured by the CRO. Here you can see the width, the rise time, the fall time, all the parameters note down to the table for different values of frequency. So this is our second experiment from this kit. Now we move on to the third experiment, which is improved multivibrator. Now we move on to the objective 3, which is to study the operation of improved free running multivibrator, and we will observe the output waveform also. So after calculating the waveform of last experiment, it has been observed that the output waveform obtained by the stable circuit does not have the vertical edges. A waveform with vertical edges is obtained by the addition of two diodes and two resistors. For this, the circuit is given in the manual. Make the connection as per the circuit diagram on the kit. So I am going to make the connections First, connect the one terminal of VC1 to diode D1 cathode. Now, anode of diode D1 will be connected to potentiometer's resistance, and other terminal of capacitor C1 will be connected to 10K resistance. Now, other terminal of C2 will be connected to R2. VC2 will be connected to diode, and terminal of C2 and diode anode will be connected to potentiometer line of resistance. So these are the connections as per the circuit diagram. Now we will observe the output waveform at the CRO. So we connect ground terminal to ground and positive terminal to point. And now we power on the circuit and observe the output waveform. As per the circuit diagram, we have made the connections. So we will power on the circuit and observe the output waveform of this S-Table multivibrator, improved free running multivibrator. So this is the output waveform at point A and also at point B, which is the square wave. As we move resistance, you can see the waveform varies. So as you see, I vary the resistance VR1 and VR2. When the waveform is not showing, that means the load resistance RB1 or we can say R5 and R6 are not identical as this time. That's why the waveform are not shown. For this, we will move the potentiometers to zero point and switch off and switch on the circuit again, and we have got the waveform on both the points. For this, the lower edge of going narrower and the upper edge of the waveform remains the same. And now for the other terminal, the upper edge goes narrower and the lower edge is constant. So that's how the S-Table multivibrators improved versions is working. This is used in frequently for square wave generations in oscillator purpose. So this is the transistor S-Table multivibrator. For any queries, please refer to the manual and contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited.